Hello and welcome. Before we get anywhere with this, I want to warn you. Nope, I don't have any insider information to say this, but I am 100% sure that Biden will raise a lot more than $500 million in August and September. I will lay out the case for you, tell you why I think Biden will raise that much money, how this impacts Trump campaign's fundraising efforts, and how this impacts this election. So number one, since May through August, Biden's monthly fundraising numbers are 81 million, 141 million, 165 million, and $365 million. It has gone up, up, and up. That's three ups in a row. So if you are a stock trader or a trend watcher, you will know that the odds are damn good for Biden to raise somewhere closer to that $365 million he raised in September, or maybe even more. But that number is so high and unheard of in any presidential campaign or entire presidential campaign fundraising history. So let's see. But the odds are certainly looking good. Biden is not going to raise $365 million in August and quickly fall down to $100 million in September. That's not going to happen because of two things. Momentum and money always brings more money with it. People like you and me are watching what's going on the money front. Donors, large as well as small, are also watching this too. One person giving makes the next person to give as well. And the same thing happens with big donors. One big donor giving, not just the next donor to give. And the cash balance Biden campaign has will allow them to invest more aggressively in convincing more donors to give them money. Think of it like extra money invested in marketing. Number two, the second part of the equation has a lot to do with what happened within the Trump campaign. In one of my earlier videos, I will try to link it somewhere if I figure out how to do that. Okay, in that video, I spoke about how Trump campaign spent nearly $800 million to go 10 points behind Biden. A lot of their money was wasted. It was spent way too early in the race. And a good portion of that $800 million went into the pockets of consultants and people who were engaged in fundraising activities. Now, even Republican-only donors will think twice before donating to the president's campaign. They also know money is flowing like a waterfall into the lake for the Biden campaign. Big donors tend to donate to both parties because they don't want to take sides, and they very well know it's important to donate to the campaign that they think will have the next president. The more they feel reluctant to open their purse for Trump's campaign, the more they feel the need to donate for Biden's campaign. Because you know, you don't want to be called as the big donor who never gave for the next president's campaign. That's the way thinking goes. Okay, I'm generalizing a little bit, but you get the picture. Money always brings more money. Trump did raise more than $1 billion. He may have wasted it by spending way too early and hiring incompetent people, but he did raise, didn't he? Now we are at the backstretch of the race, and I'm going to make a bold prediction. I expect Biden to raise $500 million to $750 million in August, September, and October. I will revise the top end of this guidance to $900 million to $1 billion if Biden raises more than $300 million in September. So far, the odds are looking good. So how does this impact this election? A lot of ways Trump campaign spending, monitored mainly through advertising spending numbers released by Axios and advertising analytics, shows that they are spending well in Florida, but keep going live and dark in several battleground states. This is not something that a campaign that has enough money will do. It's a sign of cash stress. The data shows in the last week, Trump campaign increased spending in Florida, North Carolina, Arizona, DC, Nebraska, Georgia, and Maine. But they either reduced or stopped spending on ads in Michigan, Minnesota, Wisconsin, and believe it or not, Pennsylvania. Now, Biden is spending in all of those states except for DC. Biden added $40 million to his ad spending last week. Trump added $1.1 million. Now, why would that be? Why is Trump campaign advertising in DC? And what's with Nebraska on the list for both campaigns? So, you have less than 50 days to the election and Trump does not pile on the ads in the battleground states. Now, don't give me that spin we are tactically spending, because you're not. If you are tactically spending, then why did you spend so much on ads in Pennsylvania, Michigan, Ohio, Minnesota, and Wisconsin in May, June, and July, and cut spending in September, exactly when early voting starts to kick off around the country. When you went a little dark a few weeks ago, you said that you are making use of the convention. So what's the excuse now? They are indeed rolling their ad spend between states. And if they have gone dark, I expect them to be back up again. They are doing this because their fuel is running dry, and most probably because they're looking at daily collections and rolling their spending based on that. Very soon you will start hearing that Trump won in 2016, spending half the amount Hillary Clinton spent that year. That was true. But one big factor that gets overlooked in that election cycle is the free media coverage Trump got. His outrageous comments carried so much shock value that TV networks followed him everywhere he went. Not all coverage was positive, but not all were negative. They made sure that the entire nation spoke about Trump and what he was saying. The networks carried his message, free of cost, straight inside every house. Some estimates say that the free media coverage he got was worth upwards of $5 billion. The problem this cycle is, Trump still gets a lot of free media coverage, but it's dominated by COVID, his response to COVID, and things like him swatting down CDC director for the vaccine comments he gave. The recent town hall where he spoke about herd mentality and his audio recordings with Bob Woodward, and I can keep going on. What I am trying to say is, as a president, his free media coverage is still worth in the billions, but it's mostly negative coverage, and he earned it. Free media coverage helped Trump in 2016, but it is hurting him big time in 2020. It's a difficult spot for the Trump campaign, and I expect his team to use the presidency and get Trump to travel non-stop to multiple states in the next 45 days and use his presence to generate more free, highly localized coverage from the networks. That'll be the only way for them to counter the hole they find themselves in. There is no reason for his campaign to be in this spot this late in the race. But how on earth Trump did not see that his campaign has spent all the money it raised before August? They should have kept some savings for the last 50 days, but they didn't. And that's all for today, folks. Thanks for watching.